It has happened to each and every one of us. We have taken a photo, but it looked quite bland. It didn't have any contrast and it was kind of meh. But I'm going to show you today how to fix all these problems by using Affinity Photo. So welcome to today's free photo tutorial where I'm going to show you how to bring back life from bland photos. Hello everyone, this is Strato Ayani from Illumis.com, the website and YouTube channel where we create free tutorials for Affinity Photo like this one and premium tutorials as well and courses. And I'm happy to announce that we have finally released our very first brand new course where I show you many secrets on how to create amazing portraits. You can get unlimited access to this course and all its materials. You are going to get my original RAW files and my final Affinity files as well with all the layers. And also, I'm going to be adding new content on this course in order to bring even more value. You can find out more about this course at illumis.com or at the link down below. Okay, let's see today's subject though. And today I'm going to be talking about this photo, okay? As you can see, this photo was taken during a snowstorm from Fotis Fotopoulos. I took this photo from unsplash.com and I'm mentioning the photographer's name because he's Greek just like I am. And I'm really happy to find fellow photographers online with a great profile. So if you go to Unsplash, follow Fotis Fotopoulos, has some really nice images. Now, as you can see here, a snowstorm hit Greece, and usually when we take photos with snow, our cameras tend to underexpose the photos because they see a lot of white, and we end up with a very bland, low contrast and kind of dark photo. Okay, so we're going to fix all of these problems. But how can you fix problems like this, you might ask? Well, this is what I'm going to show you in today's tutorial. So, give me a second here, because as usual, a pop-up appeared on my other monitor as I'm recording this session. Anyway, so what we want to do here is we want to explore how we can fix problems like this. The first tool you might want to use is probably the brightness and contrast option. I'm going to show you why it's not the best option. Now, brightness contrast works very simply. All you have to do is bump up the brightness by dragging this slider to the right. And if everything fades out and the colors are not, let's say, that strong, you can add some contrast and there you have it. But the problem here is that brightness and contrast work in a very strange, let's say, a non-productive way. And what I mean by that is that if we increase the brightness increases throughout the whole photo, even in areas where there is too much light or they are already too bright, meaning that we are going to get blown out areas like this one you can see here. We have no detail at all, it's overexposed because the brightness slider adds light everywhere, even to the areas that is not necessary. So it can very easily destroy our photo. So our next option is to go over here and select the levels adjustment. And once I'm going to open up this photo, I'm going to actually show you how you can use it and how you can bring your photos to life. The first thing you usually want to do is to go over here and play with the gamma. I'm going to drag it to the left in order to brighten up the whole photo. And as you can see, it is already making a great, great job, okay? We have a lot of detail in the highlights, we have a lot of detail in the shadows, everything looks just fine. Now, if you bump up the gamma, of course, you're going to lose some contrast, but you can bring back the contrast using the black level tool over here. And by slightly dragging this to the right, you can get back some color and you can get back some punchiness to the areas that are filled with color. Now, why I like this method? Because as you can see here, when I'm moving this slider, it only affects the dark areas. The bright areas remain almost untouched, okay? So I can actually control what I'm doing in my dark areas and in my bright areas, something that I cannot achieve using the brightness and contrast tool because it works everywhere, even in the areas that we don't need to do anything at all. Okay, so we can play around with the gamma in order to brighten up the whole photo. If the colors get washed out, we can bring down to the right some of the colors back by dragging the slider of the black level to the right. I'm sorry, I'm mumbling here. And if the colors are not very strong, you can always go and drop another adjustment of vibrance. And you can crank up the vibrance to your liking, maybe even a little bit of saturation, and you are going to get a much better photo, if you ask me. This is way number two, and of course way number three, probably the most known one, is you can go over here, you can throw a curves adjustment, and most people for photos like this would create an S-curve, meaning that they're going to click somewhere here and here in order to create new control points, and they're going to drag this control point to the right and downwards, this control point to left and upwards. The problem here is that although we are adding some contrast to bring some life to this photo, it gets too dark, it gets too moody. Okay, so what I instead like to do for photos like this is the following. I'm going to reset the curves. I'm going to click in the middle of the line over here, and I'm going to click and drag to the left and slightly upwards, okay? And as you can see, this photo comes back to life while I'm retaining all the details in the highlights and in the shadows, okay? And this is a before and after, before and after. And as you can see, all it takes is simply one single click, okay, to fix this photo. So there you have it. That was it. It was a quick and dirty, let's say, tutorial. Now you have three different ways that you can use in order to fix some contrast issues with your photos or some brightness issues with your photos. Well, actually we have two, because brightness contrast is kind of meh, you know. And now you can go back to your catalog and find photos that had problems and correct them very, very easily. Okay, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments down below. If you want, you can go and check out our brand new course on how to create amazing portraits using Affinity Photo. I'm going to give you a lot of advice, a lot of practical tips in an easy and step-by-step manner, and you can support us by buying this tutorial in order to keep doing what we're doing over here. And also I'm going to be adding new content, and you can get the full edited files with all the layers and also the original RAW files, so you can follow along. So go to illumis.com, find out about our course. If you have any questions, please let me know down in the comments below. And if you want to suggest a new free tutorial, again, the comment section is down here. Hit that like button because it helps, and until next time, take care and happy editing. Ciao.